Welcome back. Now, from being a small startup in Bangalore in the year 2011 to a company that's valued at over $100 million today, Hector Beverages, which owns the popular Paperboat brand, has had a pretty successful run so far. In fact, Paperboat has made a mark in the beverage industry with their lineup of traditional Indian flavors. You know that they have Aam Panna, they have Jaljeera, even Golgappe Ka Pani, and all of these have been marketed rather innovatively through these nostalgia-inducing ad campaigns that's happened over a span of time since they launched. In fact, its most recent campaign, Hum Honge Kamyab, has won it many accolades, including the coveted Grand Effie, which was something we were talking about just before the last break. Today, to talk to us about the brand and how they've gone about marketing themselves is Parvesh Debuka, the head of marketing at Hector Beverages. Great to have you with us, and many congratulations on winning the Effie this year. We'll come to that in a bit, but I want to take a step back first to understand how the idea of Paperboat came about. Why don't you take us a little bit back in time?
Yeah, so, you know, it was one of those hot afternoons in Gurgaon when Neeraj Kakkar, Neeraj Biyani, Suhas and James were having their lunch, you know, and, you know, Suhas would bring Aam Panna from home and, you know, everybody would like, you know, want to take a swig of it and they'd really love it because it was so yummy. And so one fine day when they were having that drink, James happened to mention that, guys, this is such a great drink, you know, why is it that, why don't we package something like this? You know, all of us love it, all of you guys obviously love it, so why don't we package it? And and that's pretty much how it started. And thereafter, you know, each one of us like have a specific drink that we all love, right? And so from Aam Panna, then the name of Jaljeera came up, then the name of Amras came up. And, you know, everybody started suggesting the drinks because we have all grown up with these drinks. And, you know, it used to be made at home when we grew up. So, you know, it was just something that followed, you know, as a train of thought. And we, you know, kept going in that direction.
So when you talk about product strategy, are these new flavors likely to continue? The kind of flavors that you've already introduced, you know, the nostalgia-inducing kind, the kind that are so reminiscent of the India that we know in the past, is that likely to continue in the near future as well?
So we will come out with, and we're very, very excited about it, we will come out with this drink, Neermor. It's spiced buttermilk, and that's going to be launched very soon. And we are also planning to, you know, launch Panakam, which is a drink from Karnataka. It's had on Ram Navami. So, yeah, so... And we have a couple of more that we are thinking about and we are working on.
So you've been watching the market very closely. Tell us about the kind of response you've had so far to all these offbeat flavors you've introduced. Any consumer insights, any trends that you can share with us?
Yeah, so the response has been great, honestly. And, you know, because like I grew up with Aam Panna, you know, and Amras and Jaljeera. And, you know, there are so many of us who've actually grown up with these drinks. So everybody... you know, is loving them. And one of the things that we've seen, that if you look at, you know, for instance, one question that is always asked is, you know, some of us have not grown up with some of these drinks, and now we are in, let's say, Bangalore and Bombay. So so what happens then? And the good thing is, you know, if you look at Bangalore and you look at the Pani Puri guys in Bangalore, you know, 7 years ago when I was in Bangalore in 2007, I think there were far less Pani Puri guys in Bangalore than we see today. Today there's a Pani Puri guy, you know, everywhere. So, you know, food is basically migrating and, you know, people carry their food habits with them. And we've seen that worldwide as well. So that's, and that's something that we are also seeing with our drinks. So for instance, our Kokum does quite well in a market like Delhi. Because of course, people who've grown up with Kokum are there and they're having it. And we keep getting a lot of, you know, mails from people who've discovered this new drink. And with each of these drinks, then you discover something about that place, something about the people, you know, you get to know about them a little more.
Also, why have you chosen to package this product in pouches? You have so many bottles, you have the Tetra Packs out there, but you've done it very differently. Is it to really stand out on the shelves?
No, actually, it was something that so James, he you know, he was he came with a lot of expertise in packaging, and it was just one of those things we wanted to, you know, do something which was and he had this in mind, and we said, hey, why not? There isn't something like this that's around, and you can actually create something really spectacular with this kind of packaging. So why not give it like a really good shot? And that's exactly how it happened. And when it came out finally, I think everybody fell in love with it.
Initially, I remember, Parvesh, these were most visible on airlines. Was that a conscious move to kind of make them popular on flights and then kind of take it from there?
Yeah, so one we thought was that it's a great place, like all the people who are traveling, you know, how can we, they are also the right kind of people that we are making these drinks for, because a lot of travel happens for work, you know, in all the metros. And we said that what better place to sort of serve them these drinks than on airports and aircrafts, because you're always looking out for something to eat, you're traveling at odd hours, you're tired after a long day of work, at work. So it's a great place where we can actually serve you something, and that's how we decided that, you know, and you also end up reaching out to people from everywhere, right? So people from all the places, and because we have so many different drinks, we said, let's go to the airlines. That's a good place.
All right, let's talk about ad campaigns as well, because since your launch, Paperboat has been known for all your innovative advertising. The latest Hum Honge Kamyaab campaign, that's in sync with the previous ads that you've launched. So tell us, what's the approach you've taken now with the Hum Honge Kamyaab campaign? How have you conceptualized it?
So Hum Honge Kamyaab is such a good song. It's such a favorite song of ours, and I think everybody in you know, in our company is always ready to sing that song. So even in our get-togethers, you know, at office, I think there are very few get-togethers where we haven't sung this song. So it's extremely close. All of us carry it in our hearts. And one day, you know, Neeraj said that, hey, you know, we have Hum Honge Kamyaab, you know, we all love it. Why don't we create something with that? You know, why don't we create some magic with it? And that's how it began. We went and searched for it on YouTube, and we realized that there wasn't like a well-recorded version of the song. You know, there are good versions. Of course, there are great renditions of the song. But we were trying to look for an original, basically, you know, if you know what I mean. And we didn't find that. So we said that, why don't we create something? We love it so much. Why don't we actually create something which can stay, you know, which can actually become a song that stays, you know, true to how we saw it when we were growing up. So that's how the idea came about. And yeah, and then the whole, you know, the whole point of getting all the startup people into the song, because they are such amazing people, and they are really changing our country for the better.
So as far as I can see, Paperboat ads, they've been based on themes that are related to childhood, to nostalgia. Even the use of the Malgudi theme, it takes us back in time on a huge nostalgia trip. Tell us about why you've chosen this kind of positioning, this kind of theme, as it were.
You know, again, it comes from the fact that, you know, we all have grown up with these drinks, and somehow, for instance, I'm from Jamshedpur, okay, and I'm in Bangalore right now. I left home in 2001, and I don't think I've had an aam panna. I had an aam panna, you know, away from home in all these years, till it got launched by Paperboat. So, you know, it's somewhere, to me, a lot about my childhood and how I spent my time during summer holidays, and how, you know, my mom would, you know, sort of, you know, tell me not to drink too much of amras, or not to have too much of, you know, kacham, kheri. So a lot of stories are actually attached, you know, to our childhood with these drinks. So we said that, you know, why not? Because that's exactly where it is from, in our hearts. So why not?
And Parvesh, are you doing anything spectacular in the digital space to connect better with consumers on social platforms? We know about the Facebook memories and the Instagram campaigns you've had, but we haven't really seen anything very disruptive from you, which is surprising, because you're a young, you're a quirky brand, so you can carry that off as well. So what's the thought process on the social media? What's your strategy?
So obviously, every time we do something, the intent is to do something which is genuinely good and genuinely something spectacular. That's always the intent and attempt. So Hum Honge Kamyaab was actually only for social media. We haven't done that anywhere, actually, and anywhere else, and we keep doing, right? So basically, digital is a lot of social media, and you know, and basically your own website. So Facebook, Instagram. I think we keep doing something there, which only happens in that space, because those kind of stories can only be told in that fashion, in that space. So we keep doing that, and we will always we are working towards a couple of more stories, and we will see them very soon in the next couple of months. And they're only for the digital space.
Well, considering as far as you've come right now, Parvesh, how are you planning to take the brand ahead? How are you looking at growing this market over the next few years?
So we are extremely small right now, right? And we have a really long way to go. So I think one of the key things is, how do we go to more markets? How do we go to more number of stores within the same markets? So that more number of people can, discover us. And I think that's a long journey. So that's our plan, you know, going forward, expand, try and reach, different kind of shops.
So considering that you're exploring newer markets now, going into tier 2, tier 3 cities, even rural markets in the future, how's your strategy going to change?
No, because I think the whole idea is that we will continue to, showcase the innocence. And I think innocence is the same, irrespective of where you are and where you come from. So I think it's going to be exactly the same.
Parvesh, I understand that you're looking at going beyond Indian shores as well, and the process has already started. Tell us how you're looking at being able to tap the potential that overseas markets hold right now.
We are exploring. So we were exporting actually to the US in between, and a couple of more markets. But now we are just sort of getting our structures in place and exploring some more markets outside that as well.